Hi. Do you cringe if you see a variable declaration such as this one? No? Then you should probably watch this episode of Better VBA. Hi, I'm Philip from codekabinett.com. Welcome to the sixth episode of Better VBA. Today I would like to talk about variable declaration. I had a video about variable naming a couple of months back, but this video is focusing on the technical part of variable declaration and not so much on the naming part of them. Variables are essential parts of any programming job. I think there's hardly any routine that does not need variables at all. So they are a central concept of programming in general, and of course in VBA too. So we should absolutely know what we are doing when we declare variables, and there are some constructs I see occasionally that give me the impression that the person writing the code was not entirely sure what he was doing, or he had a false idea about what's going to happen with his variable declaration. So yeah, that's what we are going to cover today. Let's get started. Today I start with a blank module, and I'm going to write a simple procedure or fragments thereof. So now I do write that line you've seen earlier. That is something I see quite frequently in other programmers' code, and I'm pretty sure it is not doing what the person writing that was expecting. Do you know what that does? I do, and it's not what you would expect. In some programming languages, that would declare two variables, foo and bar, and both are of the type string. But that is not what's happening in VBA. Put a stop statement here and run the code. And now we take a look at the variables in the locals window. And now look here, the variable bar is indeed a string. But the variable foo is not a string at all. It's a variant, because that trailing as string type definition is not having any effect on the foo variable, only on the bar variable. So this is most likely not what you were expecting if you actually do write these variable declarations in that way. What I would recommend is always put each variable on its own line. So I would write dim foo as string and dim bar as string, and now there's absolutely no ambiguity here. So that is very, very simple, but you just need to know that. And while we are at the topic of variable declaration, I want to talk about Hungarian notation for a short time. What you quite frequently see is a prefix in front of each variable, str for string. So I would have to use that here as well, or int for an integer type variable, or the same with a double goes here. And the intention of that is to make it quite clear. If I somewhere write in the code and I only see that part, the variable used, I can infer from the name that it's a variable of type integer that has some value. And I actually used Hungarian notation for quite some time, for about 10 years or so. And a couple of years ago, I stopped using Hungarian notation. I just drop those prefixes in front of the variables and I just write them this way. So I would just have this. There is the pro I already mentioned. You instantly know what type of variable you are dealing with if you see the prefix. That is something you will lose if you get rid of those prefixes. But in fact, most of the time, I think that is not that important at all. Because if I assign that value to the variable something, then I can just assume that it... something is quite a bad example, but if we change that to price and I write that, then it should be absolutely obvious that price is a numeric value, and it should be either of currency or of double. And in fact, I do not care if it's a double or a currency or maybe a single, because if I see that in the code, like I would if I write DBL price, I can't change it. So there's not really a point in seeing that here. If I really want to know what type it is, then I need to go to the declaration and look there, and then I see it's a double. And if I have to change that, then I say, okay, rather than using a double, I would rather use a currency here with just the variable name. I just change the declaration, and the line using the code does not need to be touched. While when prefixing the variable name with the abbreviation of its type, I would have to change every occurrence of that variable to reflect the changed data type of it. And so I think it's rather a bit of overhead that is not really necessary and is not that helpful to justify that. Yes, of course, you may argue I could just do a simple search and replace to change that. But why should I if I don't need to? And another point is I usually try to keep all procedures reasonably short so that wherever I am, I can just look at the variable declaration here and see that in an instant. I think I can get along pretty well without using Hungarian notation. So that is totally up to you. I'm not saying you should drop Hungarian notation, but maybe you should think about if it's really that useful. I don't think so anymore. So I dropped that. Okay, to wrap the coding part of this episode up, I want to show you something from ancient times, and I'm not sure if you have ever seen it, and it's rather a thing you should forget than memorize it. We had the declaration of variant types that are automatically declared if there's no type present. Now, you can influence that. There is a defint statement, and that statement allows me to define each variable beginning with I to K should be an integer. And I could say def str for s to x. And now I can get rid of that. And now I have these two variables without any explicit type declared. And now I run the code and show the locals window again. And now you see the I variable is indeed of type integer. And the something variable is of type string. And that is because I said, okay, any variable starting with I to K is an integer. And variables starting with S to X are of type string. And there are lots of different def statements that would define that variables beginning with a D are double. They're almost for every available type. There's a def statement where you can associate a type to the beginning of a variable name. And that is a thing from the past, and I strongly encourage you not to use this. That is, that is pretty bad, because you will not think of that if you just look at the procedure like this one. If we just hide the declaration header, and if you just look at this, you have no idea what's happening. You would assume both of those variables are variants, but they aren't. So do not use this. That is pretty rubbish. I just wanted to show you something from the past out of curiosity value, I think. Don't use that. Okay, we're almost finished for today, but I would like to come back to the topic of Hungarian notation for a minute. My example and the mistake I made with using the wrong variable to start explaining why I don't see the point in Hungarian notation anymore absolutely underlines the importance of variable naming. I think variable names are much more important than the Hungarian prefix for its type, and that is something I just forgot to mention during the coding session. So if you drop Hungarian prefixes, then you absolutely need to use good variable names. Here's the video I did about that, and maybe you should watch that if you're unsure what I'm talking about. Okay, so we're finished for today. Variable declarations are important. I did not cover any of the technical details, just the nitty-gritty stuff that sometimes gets lost if you just don't pay attention, and you absolutely should. So that's it for today. Thank you for watching, and bye-bye.